Okay, so next is the multiple diode circuits. Okay, so basically these are the steps for you to solve a circuit that has multiple diodes. So firstly, you are going to assume the state of the diode. Okay, you assume that the diode is on. So let's consider model 2, which means that the diode voltage will be V gamma. And then if you assume off, which means there will be no current, kan? Because open circuit. Okay, so you analyze the circuit with assumed diode states. Then you evaluate the resulting state of each diode. So if any initial assumptions are proven incorrect, so you're going to make new assumption and return to step 2. Okay, so how can you be sure whether your assumption is correct or not? So let's look at one example. So you have this circuit here. So I found that some students are a bit confused when they see this kind of circuit. So how can you transform this circuit into the circuit that you can make sense, that you can see the loop, you can make your mesh analysis or nodal analysis? Okay, so I'm going to show you how to do this. All right,
a few moments later,
this is the circuit that is in your slide. So the first thing you got to do is to identify the nodes that are in the circuit. Okay, so in this circuit there are two nodes, which are this one. Okay, I'm gonna call this node A, and then there is another node which is this one, node B. Okay, and also I would like to highlight there are three power supplies. Alright, so now you have identified the nodes. So now you need to construct the circuit. So the first thing you need to do is, okay, you need to define the ground. So the ground is always at the bottom. Okay, so let's start with this power supply. So for a power supply, one of the terminals is always connected to ground. Okay, so for this 0 volt, so you just draw a power supply, okay, with a plus minus sign as follows, and just connect to ground like that. So this value is 0 volt. Okay, so then it's connected to D1, right? And then this D1 is connected to node A, right? So this is my D1. So basically this branch is done. All right, next I want to deal with this branch. Okay, this R2 branch. So I'm going to draw my R2. Okay, now this power supply is minus 5 volt. So for this power supply, there are two ways for you to represent it. So you can represent it either by using the standard plus minus power supply. However, you need to put minus 5 volt. Okay? Or you can do this way. The minus is at the top, plus, and then just take the magnitude. Okay? I find that if you do this way, it will be a bit confusing for you when you do your KVL. So it's easier for you to use this method, because you just make sure the loop meets the positive sign and then take the value. Alright, so I'm going to use this method. So now, because it's connected to minus 5 volt, so I'm going to represent it as minus plus, and this just take the magnitude, which is 5 volt. So okay, for this branch is also done. We now deal with D2. This one is just straightforward. Connect your diode D2. Okay, now this diode is connected to node B. Okay, so for node B, there is this branch which is upward, right? So what you need to do is you need to flip it downward. Okay, so if you flip it downward, then the power supply will be connected to ground at the bottom. We do not want to create another ground at the top, right? So we want to make all the power supply connected to the ground below. So anyway, just draw the resistor R1. Okay, and then R1 is connected to 5 volt. It's just a straightforward power supply, plus minus, okay, 5 volt, because the value here is a positive power supply. Okay, so next, my Vout is connected to node B, which means that this is my Vout. So this label right here means that you want to calculate Vout, which is measured between node B to ground. Okay, so in this circuit, you want to measure Vout, which is from node B to ground. So now you can see a proper loop for you to do your analysis. So in the next slide, you will see how I solve it using mesh analysis.
Okay, so back to the slide. So this is the circuit you have on the whiteboard just now. Okay, so this is D2 and the current direction is as follows. So this is ID1 and this is ID2. Okay, so because these two is this direction, kan? Alright, so you can see here, I'm using mesh. Alright, so if I'm using mesh, means that I can see that there are two loops lah. So normally, the direction of my loop follows direction of the current here. So this is my loop 2. I'm going to call this loop 2. Okay, so for my loop 1 here is this direction. So you look at the current direction. So current goes this way. Right, so this is loop 1. Okay, so then you just do your KVL at loop 1 here. So we start at 5ID2. So 5ID2 is here, 5 kilo ohm, right? So 5ID2 plus 0.7 plus 10. So you can see inside here is ID2 plus ID1 because both are same direction, going downward and going downward. So that's why it's plus, alright? Minus 5 and minus 5 equivalent to 0. So then you finalize it this way. So this is your first equation, yeah? Alright. So KVL at loop 2 is this direction. So again, this is 0.7. You can see here, 0.7 plus again, you're going to add the currents because it's going downward as well. Minus 5 minus 0 equivalent to 0. And then I make this equation 10, ID2 plus ID1 equivalent to 4.3. It's because this term is also inside the first equation just now. So I'm just going to replace it straight away. So I have ID2 as 1 milliampere. But then when I calculate ID1, I obtain a negative current. So a negative diode current means that the diode is actually off. So basically our first assumption that both diodes are on is wrong. Okay, because one of it is off actually. So therefore, we need to calculate again. But now we know that diode D1 is actually off. Okay, so that's why the steps here says that you need to assume that both are on. And then based on the result of the current, you know which diode is actually on and which is actually off. Okay, so now if you go to the slide where now you know that this diode is actually off. Okay. So basically means that this diode is no longer exist. Okay, and so your circuit is already simplified to only have D2 here. Okay, because D1 is off and D2 is on. So I just proceed with using KVL. Okay, so I'm going to use the same direction like this. So 5ID2 plus 0.7 plus 10ID2 minus 5 minus 5. And I have ID2 equivalent to 0.62 milliampere. And then to find V out, you can use this loop, okay? So V out minus 5 plus ID2, okay? So plus minus here, because the current goes this way, kan? So plus is here, and you have your V out equivalent to 1.9 volt, right? So that's one example for multiple diode. Okay, so the next example actually is the same circuit, but instead of a 0 volt, they put it as 4 volt. Okay, so what happened is that the circuit just now, so now we just change it to 4 volt. Okay, so now that you have the 4 volt here, you're going to do the same mesh analysis. Do the loop again. Okay, follow direction of the current. Make sure the two currents are added. And you will get ID2 is 0.2 milliampere, which is positive. And your ID1 is also positive. So because both currents have positive values, our assumption that both diodes are on is correct. So you can proceed to calculate your V out. Okay, so to calculate V out, use this loop. So they call this loop 3, right? So V out minus 5 volt plus 5 ID2, and ID2 is here. Okay, 0.2 equivalent to 4 volt. Okay, so finally, this last example here is also a multiple diode circuit. So I'm going to just show you how to transform this into the circuit that you can do the analysis. And then I think you can use whatever method you want in order to get the answers.
this is the circuit in the question. So the first thing you need to do is to identify the nodes. You can see here is the 10 volt connected to the current source. So this is node A. Okay? So now, what do you think? Is this a different node or is it the same node? Yes, this is the same node, and that's it. That's the only node available in this circuit. Okay? So now we can start to construct the circuit. So let's start with the 10 volt. So 10 volt is a straightforward power supply. Don't forget, we want all the ground to be at the bottom. So this is my 10 volt. Alright? And then it's connected to the current source, which is to the right, connected to node A. Alright? So this is my node A just now. Okay, so this is my 5 milliampere current source. Okay, so what about this resistor here? Okay, so this resistor, we have to flip it downward, right? So if I bring my resistor here, but the diode is the one that normally students a bit confused. We know that current of the diode has to be towards node A. The current should be going towards node A as well. And therefore, the diode symbol should be like that. Okay. And next is the 5 volt supply. So 5 volt supply is the plus at the top, minus 5 volt, and then connected to ground. Okay. Next is this branch here, which is straightforward. So the diode is going downward like this, the resistor, and this one is the minus 5 volt. We use minus at the top, plus, and this one is just the magnitude. Okay. So, V out is measured at node A to the ground. So, this is again your node A. And then, this is my V out. And you measured your V out as follows. So, this is your circuit for this example. And I hope you can try to do your mesh analysis or nodal analysis to get the parameters and compare with the answers given in the slide. So, thank you. I'll see you again. Assalamualaikum. Bye.